There are many variants of linear regression based on the regularization they apply. But in this video, we will broadly talk about ridge, lasso and elastic net. This video walks you through with the explanation of regularization, intuition of ridge, lasso and elastic net, and also their mathematics till implementing this algorithm in Python from scratch. Okay, let's begin. First of all, what is regularization? Linear regression suffers from a huge problem of overfitting. If you have less data for training linear regression, it will definitely overfit and make unnecessary complex relationship with data even if it is not needed. Not only linear regression, but every model in machine learning will overfit the data if you will not put any constraints. In this example, we only have two training data points, and linear regression perfectly passes through it. So for the training set, it has zero error. But now, if I make test data visible or give my same linear regression model to predict it, it will do a horrible job. These yellow lines are the error made by our model. To avoid this, we do regularization. It is the first thing every machine learning developer will do to avoid overfitting. It is like penalizing or punishing our model for doing wrong. This is a new line formed after regularization. We will discuss how this new line is formed in the mathematics section. You can clearly see the new error is less than the error of the previous line. This is the length of error of our linear regression line. But for regularized line, it is much less than that. From these braces, we can see how much error is reduced. Okay, now when you have gained a normal intuition of regularization, let's dive into some mathematics. Regularization is nothing but a small amount of penalty added to loss function. The most common type of regularization is L1 and L2 regularization. In L2 regularization, we add lambda into square of weights to our loss function. This is also known as Tikhonov regularization. In L1 regularization, we just change that square to the absolute value of weights. Here, lambda is the strength of regularization. We will discuss it with a matplotlib animation in a moment. Simple as that. Loss function can be anything. Like in linear regression, we use mean squared error. In SVMs, we use hinge loss. In logistic regression, we use binary cross entropy. But this video is dedicated to linear regression, so just focus on that mean squared error. Mean squared error is Y true or ground truth values that we have given to our model during the training phase and minus the Y predicted, which is the predicted value by our model. The whole divided by M, which is the total number of rows in the past data. This is all about basic maths of regularization, but what this all is to do with lasso ridge in elastic net? Let us discuss that now. Ridge regression applies L2 regularization and lasso regression applies L1 regularization. We will see their mathematics in a moment. Elastic net does a cool thing which I have to show you with a cool animation. Elastic net is intermediate between lasso and ridge as it applies both L1 and L2 regularization in the same equation. And one more cool thing is that we can control this behavior of elastic net with a hyperparameter known as L1 ratio in scikit-learn. We will discuss more about this parameter in elastic net's mathematics part. Now we will cover ridge regression mathematics. As we discussed, linear regression uses mean squared error as its loss function and ridge regression applies L2 regularization. I have just added those things and what we have got now is the cost function of ridge regression. Simple as that, nothing complex, mean squared error plus the L2 regularization. This all regression algorithm use gradient descent for finding the minimum or optimal values of weights and biases. For that, we have to calculate the partial derivative of this cost function with respect to weights and then with respect to bias. If you don't know about partial derivatives, this article by mathisfun.com is highly recommended. Let's move forward. Now we have substituted y predictors as wx plus b. I have discussed in depth about the equation y is equal to mx plus b in this video. And then we find the partial derivative of cost function j theta with respect to weights. For step-by-step solution of the equation, you can see my article on Medium. And then we do the same with respect to bias. and then we can use these two equations in gradient descent to find the optimum values of weights and biases. Here the learning rate is how slow or fast the learning process should be. If you don't know what gradient descent is, try seeing some videos as it is most fundamental thing used by most of the ML algorithms. Let's move to Lasso. Lasso uses the same mean squared error loss function, but this time we will apply L1 regularization and will repeat the same steps. Here comes the elastic net. Now we will again do the same thing, take the mean squared error loss function and then add it with both L1 and L2 regularization. But here we can see one more term which was not there in the previous equation. As I said, elastic net acts as both lasso and ridge, and we can control this with a hyperparameter known as L1 ratio. But when we write it mathematically, we denote it as R. You can set a value of R anything between 0 to 1, but how our model changes with that value? So let me play that previous animation again, but this time there is one more term, L1 ratio. Now it is at 0.5, so it will behave like lasso and ridge equivalently, but as we start decreasing the value from 0.5 to 0, elastic net starts to behave roughly as ridge, but at 0 it will completely behave as ridge. Note, I am not saying it will completely become ridge, I am saying it will completely behave as ridge. Same for the right side. If we start changing our value from 0.5 to 1, elastic net will start behaving like lasso, and at 1 it will completely behave as lasso. Now you can calculate the partial derivative of our elastic net cost function with respect to weights and then with respect to bias. So this was all about the mathematics stuff. Now I would like you to show some matplotlib plots and animation. Here I have trained linear regression and ridge regression on this training data. All these x's are the training data and all these dots are my test data. I have intentionally kept the size of my test data larger than the trained data. So linear regression makes a linear relationship with the data which will give the minimum amount of squared residuals, but we are applying some penalty to our ridge regression. And when ridge reaches a point where it is completely equal to linear regression, it has higher value of loss function compared to linear regression. So ridge tries to do even better, and ridge reaches to this type of line which ultimately fits data more efficiently. So if I zoomed into these 3 points of my test data, my plot will look like this. Here you can see the error of linear regression line with respect to these 2 dots are higher than the ridge regression. But for this point, ridge regression has higher error, but summing these 2 errors and subtracting this from it, it will give a value which is still higher, meaning this small error turns out to be negligible. As we know that this all algorithm make use of gradient descent to find an optimum line which fits data perfectly. But how this looks like? This is a slow-mo video of convergence. In reality, it is so fast that we are unable to see the line. Let me start the video. So here comes the line and it slowly converging. Okay, it has found the optimum position and now it has stopped moving as it has converged. Let me go back again. So if you can see, our line is here in starting, as we are initializing our weights and biases as 0, and then it oscillates around the points and finally converges. So beautiful. The last thing is how our model changes with respect to the value of lambda. which I previously said as strength of regularization. So you can see the value of alpha here, and this red line is the ridge and blue is lasso. Let me start the video. Now back again. As you can see, lasso deviates the point so much faster than ridge. By this, we can conclude that lasso is more sensitive to the changes in the value of alpha, but ridge changes in constant speed. This was all about the theory stuff. Now let us get implement this crazy thing in Python from scratch. First, I will make a new Python file named linearmodel.py. Then I will make the class named ridge regression. In it, I will make three functions, namely init, fit, and predict. Init will accept hyperparameter values, which will be used in training. Fit will take x and y values and train our algorithm using gradient descent. And last, the predict function will predict the incoming x values. Now let us list those parameters. Here I have named a hyperparameter named alpha, but in the mathematics section, we write it as lambda. So scikit-learn names it as alpha, so I have done the same. Nothing changes, you can denote it by whatever letter you want. Fit values take x and y values for training purposes, and then we will initialize our weights and biases as 0. As training proceeds, our algorithm will try to find the optimal values of these. Now we will write predict function, as we will need it in fit function. Predict will return the dot product of x and weight plus the bias. Now it's time to run a for loop. This for loop will run max iter times, meaning if the max iter value is set to 2000, then it will run 2000 times. The default is 1000. In every iteration, we will call the predict function and store the predicted values by our model in the variable yPred. This is because we have to calculate the loss, and then I will paste the formula of partial derivative of the ridge regression cost function with respect to weights, denoted here by LW, and biases, denoted here as LB. We have discussed this in the math section, and then using gradient descent, we will reduce loss function and change the value of weights and bias. This is the entire algorithm that is able to train and predict. I will copy this entire thing and just change ridge regression to lasso regression, because everything remains the same except the formula of partial derivative. Let me paste the lasso's formula of LW and LB. And we have also made lasso regression. And then I will repeat the same, copying the entire thing and updating the value of LW and LB by ElasticNet's actual value. Now let us test our algorithm. I will create a new file named testing.py, and we will import ridge regression class from our linearmodels.py. Now we will create data where the relationship between x and y is equal to 2x plus 1. Here 2 is the value of weights and 1 is the bias. X contains all the values from 1 to 10. We will convert the values of x and y from a normal Python list to a NumPy array. Let us call our ridge class, and here we will set the learning rate as 0.05 and max iter to be 2000. Then we will fit our x and y values, and after the model is trained, we will print the final weights and bias values calculated by our model. Also, we will say our model to predict what will be the y value if x value is 20. Let's run the code. Our model has evaluated weights as 1.977, bias to be 1.119, and predicted y value is 40.67. Actual value is 41, which is also close. Now we will change max iterals from 2000 to 4000. So our model will have more than 2000 iterations to reach more better optimal values. The values are still the same. Now we will change the learning rate to 0.04. The values are still the same, and again change to 0.01 and again run. Wow, the prediction is now very close to 41. Basically, this is trial and error. You can tweak this hyperparameter to find even more optimal values. Now we will calculate the mean squared error. The mean squared error is 0.001, which is too good. Let us plot our prediction and see how much good rich regression has fitted to our data. The line perfectly passes through all the data points. Good, now your task is to try this with Lasso and ElasticNet. The whole code of today's video is available in this repository. This was it for today's video. I will see you next time. Till, keep learning.